Hey, it's Medicosis Perfect Nails, where medicine makes perfect sense. Today we have an introduction to virology. On my channel, I have talked about JC virus before, and we have compared it to JC penny, just a mnemonic. Now it's an introduction. So let's get started. Some words of wisdom. The question is not whether the glass is half empty or half full, but whether the glass started out empty or started out full. We divide microbes or microorganisms to bacteria, fungi, viruses, and parasites. I know that the public refers to bacteria as bugs, but actually, technically, bugs are only parasites. They are a subgroup of parasites. First, what does virology mean? Ology means a study of, and vir is viruses, the study of viruses. Viruses are unique, unlike cells. So, what are cells? Cells can replicate independently, cells can make their own proteins, cells can produce energy, and cells can be seen by light microscopy. However, viruses are not cells. Why? They cannot replicate independently, they cannot make their own proteins, they cannot produce energy, they cannot be seen by light microscopy, only by an electron microscope. Also, viruses have neither a nucleus nor a cytoplasm. If you have watched my playlist on biology, I've told you about the four fundamental concepts of the cell theory. All living things are composed of cells. The cells are the basic functional unit. Cells arise only from pre-existing cells. Viruses cannot do that. Cells carry genetic info in the form of DNA and RNA together. But what about me? Viruses are weird because they are not cells. Viruses are not living organisms. They are kind of in between living and non-living. They are, quote, at the edge of life, unquote. Why do you consider them non-living? Because they cannot replicate independently. They cannot make their own energy, let alone synthesize their own proteins. They lack cellular structures. They are small infectious agents discovered in 1892. They are transmitted via vectors. And they replicate very quickly. That's why we say go viral. No one says go bacterial. These viruses need to infect a cell of the host, and then it can replicate using your own cell as a DNA making machine. DNA or RNA, of course. For instance, HIV infects your T lymphocytes and uses the T lymphocytes' genetic material to make its own nucleic acid. We can compare between cells and viruses in a beautiful table. Cells, they replicate by mitosis or binary fission. Viruses do not do this. Cells have a cell membrane in every cell. What about the cell wall? Yeah, some bacteria have a cell wall, some fungi. Yeah, I get it. However, all of them, like bacteria, fungi, parasites, have a cell membrane. And your human body, because you have cells. Viruses, they sometimes have an envelope, some of them, not all of them. In your cell, you have nuclear material, you have DNA and RNA at the same moment. But viruses either have DNA or RNA, not both, never ever. Cells, the proteins are many. In viruses, proteins are few. In cells, ribosomes are present. Viruses, ribosomes are absent. With only tiny exception, the arena virus. And even the ribosomes in the arenavirus are non-functional, talking about misfortune. And then the mitochondria in your cells. If you're prokaryote, they're absent. If you're eukaryotes, like you and me, present. Mitochondria are absent from viruses. In the cells, we have lots of enzymes, but viruses, the enzymes are few or non-existent. Look at this. It makes sense because the proteins are few, and since enzymes are proteins, enzymes are also few. It's called common sense. Viruses. As a virus, I have either DNA or RNA, but never both. I have protective protein coat surrounding my nucleic acid. And sometimes I have an envelope, depending on the type of the virus. Proteins are few, therefore enzymes are few. I have no nucleus, no cytoplasm. Ribosomes are absent, mitochondria are absent. I've told you before that viruses are either DNA or RNA. DNA includes 7 viruses, RNA includes 15 viruses, and you can sing the song with Help Hippo. Check out his YouTube channel. If you remember mathematics, since and therefore, let's play that game. Since viruses cannot produce energy or make their own proteins, therefore they cannot replicate outside the cell. I'm alone, I cannot do anything. They have to be inside the host cell in order to replicate. Therefore, viruses are obligate intracellular parasites.
But you told me that viruses are different from parasites.
Yeah, quote unquote, it's as if they are parasites because they are obligate intracellular. And then when they infect your cell, they use your cell as a DNA making machine. DNA or RNA, of course, depending on the freaking virus. Right now, my cardiac pharmacology course is available on my website and it has a discount and you can download a free sample. To receive 50% discount, use the promo code CardioPharm50. This is available for 19 students only. If you didn't catch it, try this one. MedicosisPerfectionalis.com. 50 videos, baby. If you like this video, smash like, subscribe, hit the bell, and click on the join button. You can support me here or here. You can send me an email. You can go to my website to get my cardiac pharmacology course and my antibiotics course. Thank you so much for watching. As always, be safe, stay happy, and study hard. Until next time, this is Medicosis Perfectionalis, where medicine makes perfect sense.